This movie answers every question you have, except one. When Mickey Rooney is in his I'm being a dick because I am successful phase of this movie, they are at Café Argentina. And he's gonna buy, you know, some people drinks because he's hotshot and all that stuff. These people, these fucking people, want to have gin in their champagne. Was that a thing in the 1940s? I don't know. But anyway, if anybody would ever ask me for some gin in their champagne or champagne in their gin, I would take the bottle of champagne and I would use that on them, what Captain Ramirez did on the poachers in Pan's Labyrinth. So don't even think about it. This is the big wheel. Mickey Rooney plays Billy Coy. His father was called the Cannonball and was a famous race driver. He unfortunately died in one of his races, and his mother feared that Billy is going to suffer the same thing because he wants to be a race driver too. Only by name recognition only, he, you know, goes to his old acquaintances of his father and see if they can get him into the business. He is a very competent driver and becomes a huge star in the world of midget racing car. Is that what it is? I think it was called that. It's weird. It's these very small cars that look kind of like these cars in Monopoly that you often are the first guy to choose when you're playing Monopoly. Not only does he find some success, he also finds love in the shape of Dolores, who is their tomboy grease monkey in the garage where his father turns up. However, success also turns him to a bit of a bellend who becomes a bit of a dick and a bit of an asshole, and things rises to his head. And there's also one of the parts where I sort of toned out and became very disinterested. Now, it also should be mentioned that this movie, because it's made in 1949, it's not any fancy cuts or, it's not cut like a music video. The camera holds very steady when they go around and around and around and around. Can you stop? Go around, please. Yeah, so the races are not very interesting. In fact, they are so, so boring. It's just all the time, and you get actively bored very fast. When Sweet William turns into Big Bad Billy, that was a Van Halen reference, by the way, if you got that one, then you also lose interest in what's gonna happen to him. And also, even though the entire I'm being a dick is a bit of a dropped storyline, so is the romance with Dolores, which sort of just disappears before it has, gotten off the ground, really. And I'm kind of sad by that, because I liked Dolores. She was a sweet girl. But I was ready to just axe this movie off. But the last 10, maybe 12 minutes of this one was very exciting, because it is the Indy 500, and they make it look extremely big and extremely, massive. Mainly because they actually shot it in the Indy 500, which might be a little bit of a cheating, but it's okay, I guess. The stakes are higher, the movie looks big, the crashes look great. Also, all the participants are elevated by like 10, so the movie feels bigger, the story is better, and it actually has a very satisfying and nice conclusion. So yeah, 90% bad, 10% really, really exciting. So apart from the very boring sequences with the cars going around and around and around, it has a very exciting finale, and it will turn out the rating of 30. It does have some pretty good acting, and it does have some interesting characters in the entire thing, although Mickey Rooney isn't really one of them. I was never a big fan of his, and this is nothing that really changed my mind on him. I don't necessarily like racing movies or sports movies at all. This was just a very old one that worked so and so. So that's it for today. I'll be seeing you next time from so and so, where I will be reviewing, well, such and such. Thank you for watching. Thank you very much.